Planes are flying machines that have wings and are propelled by engines or propellers. They are used for transportation, recreation, exploration, or warfare. They can fly at high altitudes and speeds and can carry people or cargo over long distances. But who were the first plane builders and how did they make their planes fly? Let's take a look at the science behind it. The history of plane building goes back to ancient times when people observed the flight of birds and insects and tried to imitate them. Some of the earliest attempts at flying were made by using kites, balloons, gliders, or ornithopters. However, these devices could not fly by their power or control their direction or altitude. Two brothers from Dayton, Ohio, Orville and Wilbur Wright, invented the first plane that could fly by its power and control its flight. The Wright brothers were not the first to attempt to build an airplane, but their approach was based on a deep understanding of aerodynamics and the principles of flight. They designed and built their wind tunnel to test various wing shapes and sizes, and they developed a system for controlling the pitch, roll, and yaw of their airplane. The Wright brothers decided to build their gliders and test them at Kitty Hawk, North Carolina, where they found steady winds and soft sand for landing. They made several improvements to their gliders, such as adding a movable rudder and a wing warping mechanism to control the direction and balance of the plane. In 1903, they added a gasoline engine and two wooden propellers to their glider and created the first airplane. On December 17, 1903, they made the first successful flight in the history of a powered airplane. Orville piloted the plane for 12 seconds and covered 120 feet. Wilbur flew the next flight for 59 seconds and covered 852 feet. They made two more flights that day, each longer than the previous one. The Wright brothers solved the problem of powered flight by using three principles: lift, thrust, and control. Lift is the upward force that keeps the plane in the air. It is generated by the shape of the wings, which create a difference in air pressure above and below them. Thrust is the forward force that moves the plane through the air. It is generated by the engine and the propellers, which push air backward. Control is the ability to steer and stabilize the plane. It is achieved by using the rudder, which changes the direction of the plane, the elevators, which change the altitude of the plane, and the wing warping mechanism, later replaced by ailerons, which changes the angle of the wings. The Wright brothers continued to improve their planes and made more flights in different places. They also faced many challenges and dangers, such as patent disputes, competition from other inventors, accidents, and injuries. They also had to convince people that their planes were real and practical. They demonstrated their planes to the public and potential buyers, such as governments and military forces. The Wright brothers are widely recognized as the inventors of the first airplane and the fathers of modern aviation. Their planes inspired many other people to build their planes and explore new possibilities of flight. Today, planes are used for various purposes and have different designs and features, but they all owe their existence to the first planes built by Orville and Wilbur Wright. Nowadays, we have airplanes for many different purposes: military airplanes, passenger airplanes, or for transporting cargo. We even have firefighting airplanes. But which plane is the biggest in the world? How do we measure the size of a plane? And how does such a huge plane stay aloft in the air? There are different ways to measure the size of a plane's same ship, such as its length, width, height, weight, volume, or capacity. Depending on the criteria used, different planes may rank as the biggest in the world. For example, the longest plane ever built was the Hughes H-4 Hercules, also known as the Spruce Goose, a wooden flying boat that measured 66.7 meters from nose to tail. It was also the widest plane ever built, with a wingspan of 97.8 meters. However, it only flew once for 26 seconds in 1947. The largest plane by gross weight, the total weight of the plane and its contents. The Antonov AN-225 Mriya is a Ukrainian cargo plane that can carry up to 250 tons of payload. It has a gross weight of 640 tons and a length of 84 meters. It is also the largest plane by wingspan, measuring 88.4 meters across. The largest plane by passenger capacity is the Airbus A380-800, a European double-decker airliner that can carry up to 853 passengers in a single-class configuration. It has a length of 72.7 meters and a wingspan of 79.8 meters. It has a gross weight of 575 tons. So how does such a massive plane fly in the air? The answer lies in the principles of aerodynamics, which explain how air flows around objects and how forces are generated by moving air. These forces include lift, thrust, drag, and weight. The main components of an airplane that generate lift are the wings. Wings are designed with a curved shape, called an airfoil, which helps to create different air pressures above and below the wing as air flows over it. The shape of the wing causes the air flowing over the curved top to move faster than the air flowing beneath the flat bottom. According to Bernoulli's principle, which states that faster moving fluids exert less pressure than slower moving fluids, this causes the air pressure above the wing to be lower than the air pressure below the wing. This pressure difference creates an upward force, called lift, that can lift the airplane off the ground. So, how does the AN-225 Mriya fly? Like all airplanes, it relies on the principles of aerodynamics to generate lift and stay aloft. The shape of the wing, known as an airfoil, is specially designed to maximize lift while minimizing drag. In addition to lift, the AN-225 Mriya also relies on its engines to generate thrust and move through the air. The plane is powered by six Progress D18T turbofan engines, each producing 51,590 pounds of thrust, allowing it to achieve takeoff and maintain cruising speed. The AN-225 Mriya also has a sophisticated control system that allows pilots to adjust the plane's pitch, roll, and yaw. This system includes flaps and ailerons on the wings and rudder and elevator controls on the tail. By adjusting these controls, pilots can steer the plane and maintain stability during flight. However, tragedy struck on February 27, 2022, when the only completed AN-225 was destroyed in the Battle of Antonov Airport during the 2022 Russian invasion of Ukraine. The aircraft was attacked by Russian forces at its base in Hostomel, near Kyiv. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky announced plans to complete the second AN-225 to replace the destroyed aircraft, and Antonov announced plans to rebuild the destroyed aircraft in November 2022. In this video, we explored the science behind airplanes and how they fly. Like ships, airplanes seem to defy the laws of gravity, but they are one of the most amazing examples of how we can use the power of physics to our advantage. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share with your friends. You can write your thoughts and ideas about the video in the comments. See you next time.